This look might be a little bit familiar to the ELLE Canada reader, and that's because it was featured on one of the models in the Eccentrics shoot in the September issue. The Eccentrics shoot is aptly named, and that's because it's wild. It's this crazy clash of beautiful, bold prints and textures, and I found that the hair and makeup really helped to balance it out as well as complement all of the things that were going on in that shoot. I think that the hair really expresses the youthful exuberance of the entire Eccentrics photo shoot and that beautiful eclectic house. It's an editorial sleek take on the half up, half down, messy bun look that I quite literally have been wearing almost every single day this summer. And it also recalls that samurai style top knot that the boys have been wearing. I love this clash of masculinity and femininity, and I think that it just really brings a little bit more of that youthful side to the entire look. I think that there are also some subtle grown-up elements to the shoot that help to round everything out, and the makeup artist was really smart at using more of a sultry, grown-up, smudgy, smoky eye that helped to also balance out the youthful top knot that we've got going on today. All in all, I think that this is a really well-rounded, perfectly balanced look that's super fun. And if you're interested to see how I got the look, keep on watching. You might notice that my hair is slightly damp, and that's because I had a shower before filming, and I used the shampoo and conditioner that I was sent in the box this week. These are the Pantene Pro-V Expert Collection Dry Defy Shampoo and Conditioner. These are supposed to replenish moisture and hydration into your hair that you might have lost through heat styling or environmental factors. This shampoo is supposed to reduce frizz and help your hair stay a lot softer. Now that my hair is damp, it's the perfect time to start using some styling products. So I'm using the Marc Thickening Cream. This is a collagen bamboo cream that's supposed to wrap all the way around the shaft of each individual hair and add plumpness and thickness. The product looks kind of like this. It's a really thick, almost opaque white gel. I'm just going to run it through my hair at the roots. Next, because I'm going to be doing some heat styling, I'm going to run a little bit of the L'Oreal Extraordinary Oil Penetrating Oil through the tips of my hair. I love using an oil on my hair, not only because it gives you a really glossy, shiny finish, but it also protects the roots, particularly of your hair, from heat styling. So I'm just going to take one pump of that and run it through the ends of my hair. Now I'm going to go ahead and use the T3 Featherweight Luxe 2 Eye Hair Dryer that I was sent. When I saw this in the box, I was so excited because this is used by pro hairstylists, by celebrities, by beauty editors everywhere. It's known for its high-tech design. It's designed so that it dries your hair faster while creating less damage through heat styling. And I think that the actual overall appearance of it reflects it too. It's got this beautiful chrome reflective finish, a prismatic bezel at the barrel, and then even a futuristic looking back to the barrel as well. It's got the normal features that you expect from a high-end hairdryer, such as a cool shot, various heat settings, and then intensity sections for the blower. The hairdryer also comes with this T3 Tourmaline Ionic Bristling Brush, and I like that this one has a hollow core, and not only does that let hot air flow through and dry your hair faster, but it also reduces the damage from heat styling. The hairdryer and the brush in combination together are known to smooth out the hair as well as seal the cuticle, so your heat style lasts for longer. So my hair is completely dry now. I really like the combination of the brush and the hairdryer. I found that the products helped my hair feel at once thicker at the root, volumized throughout, and then very nice and soft and silky smooth at the ends. So now I'm going to get my hair out of the way of my face for the makeup portion of the tutorial. I'll come back to the hair at the end of the video. But I love these goodie clips that I was sent. They're a medium size jaw clip, but on the inside you have rubberized areas that really grip onto the hair and make sure that it doesn't slip around. So I've already moisturized and primed my face, which is always important to give you more youthful model-like skin, and I'm going to use the Too Faced Born This Way foundation that I was sent. It's infused with hyaluronic acid, alpine rose, and coconut water, and all these three things are supposed to help infuse hydration into your skin and really plump up all the cells and make everything look really glowy. I love the frosted glass on the bottle, and I think that the pump is really useful, and I'm just going to get some of that onto the back of my hand. Taking my damp sponge, and I'm just going to apply it all over my face. So immediately the coverage from this foundation is a demi-matte, medium, buildable to heavy coverage. It feels very thin on the face though, so it doesn't feel like you're wearing a ton of cakey makeup, but it's still very luminous, which I really like. Overall, I really like the appearance of this foundation. I love that it's called Born This Way. I'm not only a sucker for packaging, but I'm also a sucker for marketing. And I think that that name just invokes this idea of the skin that you are born with, this perfect, flawless skin. Like, all of us who wear this foundation just look like we were born this way with skin like this. I think it's just, it's great marketing, and I think it's also a great product. Next, I'm going to use a peachy toned corrector that will help to cancel out the dark circles under my eyes. I'm going to take care of some of the areas that I find need a little bit more help, such as the bridge of the nose with a little bit more concealer. I'm going to set it all down with powder, and then I'll start with the eyebrows. The model had really beautiful, straight, and thick eyebrows, so I'm going to try to mold my eyebrows, which have a slightly more arched look to them naturally. I'm just going to fill in the lower part of the arches to even that out, and I'm going to add a little bit more length on either side. Next, to set the eyebrows in place, I'm going to use the Rimmel Brow This Way Brow Styling Gel, and I like that it's a really thick gel with a lot of pigment to it, so you can actually use it alone without filling in your eyebrows, and it has a tiny little spoolie. This one is in dark brown, and I'm going to brush my hair horizontally instead of vertically. You've seen me brush my hairs vertically countless times on this channel, I feel like almost in every video, but because I want to get that length, I'm going to focus the horizontal strokes for this. I'm going to start by priming my eyelids with the Urban Decay Eyeshadow Primer Potion in Eden. I love the formula of this primer potion, and I love that it's a pale yellow color that will really help to cancel out any bluish veins on your eyelids, because the skin on the eyelids is actually the thinnest on your entire face, so it's more likely to show through all of the things that are underneath. I really like that they repackaged the product to have a doe foot applicator, and I think that it just makes the application, especially the portion, because you don't need a lot of this, really, really foolproof. One of the things that I think was the most on trend for the eye makeup for this look was the waterline black kohl that just ringed the eyes. It's super punky, and I find that it just adds a really cool bad girl vibe, like an insouciance to the look. And for that, I'm going to be using this Chanel waterproof eyeliner in Pomme de Pin. I think that's a really cute name, and if anybody's been watching any of the videos that I've been doing for this channel, you'll know that I love the little sharpener that comes on the back of these pens, because it twists up easily, you can just sharpen it, and you have a perfect point for your eyeliner every single time. I love how pigmented and smooth this pencil is. It's really easy to apply. As you can see, I didn't do a very precise application. I more so smudged along the lash line as well, and I'm going to help blend that out with the use of some eyeshadows. This is the Maybelline The Blushed Nudes palette. I think that all of these beautiful blush tone, dusty rose pinks and cranberries and rose golds are super on trend at the moment. With just a clean blending brush, I'm going to take this first sort of shimmery shell shade. And I'm going to apply this all over to the lid and all the way up to the brow bone. Then I'm going to take this shade here, which is a rich chocolate brown with a little bit of a gold shimmer, and I'm going to start working that into the lash line just really haphazardly. And then I just blended everything up. Just going to take a fine amount of that brown color just on the tip and run that along the lower lash line. Now I'm taking a flat shadow brush with a little bit of a bronze color, and I'm just going to pat this all over the eyelid. I'm also going to take more of that bronze shade under the lower lash line. A fluffy. Next, I'm going to take a matte taupe shade, taupey brown actually, and I'm just going to run that in the crease just to enhance the socket of my eye and to blend the bronze into the rest of the colors. Now what I'm doing is taking a fluffy brush and just blowing out the crease, actually, as they call it, which is just another way for saying blending and diffusing the color. My most favorite part of the eye look is she had a lot of gold on the inner corner of the eye, which I think helps to really illuminate and brighten and widen the eyes. So I'm going to take a little bit of a gold pigment and put that right in the middle with this pencil brush. And I'm just using that same brush that I applied all of that gold pigment with, just to blend it into the rest of the color. Lastly, for the eyes, I'm going to go in with the new NARS Audacious Mascara. This scared the heck out of me at first because there are super spiky bristles to this and they're sort of alternating in length. But the great thing about it, now that I've applied it, is that the short bristles help to pick up lots of color and deposit that rich pigment at the root of the eyelashes. And then the spikes, the longer spikes, help to really add length. I've never experienced one clump with this mascara. Because this is an editorial look, I'm going to show you what I think the makeup artist did at first, which was basically just concentrate all of the color into the root of the eyelashes. But as you can see, even with that technique, I still have really long and fluttery eyelashes that have absolutely no clumps. I really think this mascara is amazing. I'm going to complete the face by chiseling out some model cheekbones. I'm going to use a taupey gray cool tone brown that will help me just really chisel out a shadow underneath my cheekbones. Next, on the lips, the model had this beautiful darker pink on the outside, almost like a rosewood color, and then a peachy color on the center of the lip. So I'm going to try to recreate it with two lipsticks that I was set today. I'm going to use the Rimmel Lasting Finish by Kate Moss lipstick. This is one of my most favorite formulas from the drugstore in terms of lipstick, and I also love nudes, so you know this is just screaming my name. This is a really beautiful, as I said, like a rosewoody mauve nude. This would be also great on darker skin tones. I'm just going to apply it directly from the bullet. For the peachy pink center of the lip, I'm going to use the Burberry Kisses lip color in number 1, Nude Beige. This is supposed to be a sheer but very buildable lip color, and I like that for using it on the center of the lip because I find that it'll really help me blend the two colors together. And also, before I even get to the product, look at how beautiful the packaging is. It just reflects light. I could stare at it like this as I turn it around as it reflects light all day long. It's absolutely stunning. I also love the nod to the brand with the etching into the actual lipstick tube. And then when you open it up, it's also been imprinted into the product. As I said, this is a beautiful peachy beige nude, and I'm just going to take it from the bullet as I did with the last lipstick and just apply it to the center of the lip. This one is also super creamy, and I love the sheen that it gives in the center of the lip. It'll also make your lips look more plump and fuller. So there's the finished makeup look. Now I'm going to go back to the hair and show you how to get that half up, half down, top knot bun twist look that I think is just so perfect for the wacky nature of the eccentric shoot. So I've unclipped my hair and I'm just going to take a fine tooth comb with a rat tail end and using that rat tail end just to separate out where I would like my hair to be half up and half down. The ratio of half up, half down that I think is good, I'm going to take that rat tail again and just pick out sections from the front of the hair. She had this cool sort of faux widow's peak going on, so I'm going to try to recreate that as well. Then I'm taking this flat tooth side of the comb and really getting everything nice and straight and flush to the side of my head. So now with the hair right on the top of my head, I'm going to start to twist it. And when it starts to twist onto itself, I'm going to guide it into a vertically integrated top knot. And then securing the sides down with an elastic. So at this point, I've plugged in my hair straightener, and while I'm waiting for that to heat up, I'm just going to quickly brush through my hair to make sure that there are no knots. And it's ready. If you can remember to the beginning of the video, I've already used a styling oil, and that will help to maintain the integrity and health of my hair, even though I'm using a hot tool on it. And the model's hair is really beautiful, pin straight, so I'm just going to try to do that with my hair. So here's the finished look. This hair is so fun, it's hard for me to get it into the entire shot, but this is my take on the model's look in the eccentric shoot in Elle Canada's September issue. If you enjoyed this look, make sure to hit subscribe so you don't miss any more of the videos in the Beauty Playlist series. Also leave a comment down below suggesting what you would like to see in this series. If you recreate this look, and I don't see why anyone wouldn't want to, you should send me a picture by tagging at Elle Canada and at Marisa Roy and using the hashtag Beauty Playlist on Facebook, Instagram, or Twitter. Until next time, remember the lessons that the eccentric shoot taught us. Don't be afraid to be a little bit weird, be colorful, be bright, be youthful, and don't forget to be yourself. I'll see you next time. Bye!